convergence of AI and quantum computing is positioned to drive Africa's digital transformation across sectors like healthcare, finance, and energy by enabling advanced problem solving. CNBC Africa is now joined live by Jack Hidary for more on this and what it could mean for business. Many thanks, Jack, for joining us all the way in Abu Dhabi. Of course, I know quite a number of discussions happening down there, but I just want us to start with, are there any announcements you've made as a company out of this forum?
Abby, great to be with you here from Abu Dhabi, here at the ADIPEC conference, biggest energy conference in the world. Both AI and quantum topics here. AI, of course, everyone knows about AI for the digital world, ChatGPT, Google Gemini, many others as well. But now here at ADIPEC, we're talking about AI for the physical world, AI to make better batteries. In the continent of Africa, for example, where we want to store electrons from solar, from wind, from traditional sources, we need better stationary batteries to store it and then deploy it when we need it. That is not AI, digital AI, that's not ChatGPT, that's large quantitative models, models that understand physics, chemistry, energy. And that's what we're talking about here at ADIPEC today.
Quite interesting, and perhaps talk to me about some of the opportunities you see in Africa and perhaps what are some of the inroads that companies are already making?
Well, continent of Africa, 1.5 billion people, one of the fastest growing populations in the world, fastest growing also in terms of energy usage. Today across the continent of Africa, we're looking at about 800 terawatt hours of energy usage, but growing very, very fast. And for that, we're going to have to supply all kinds of energy. When we think about hydrocarbons, Nigeria, many other countries in Africa produce oil. How do we turn that oil into useful products? We need what's called a catalyst. Catalysts are those compounds, Abby, as you know, that we use to drive those reactions forward to make useful fuels and products in the world. We just announced last week with NVIDIA at SandboxAQ a new AI that helps us make catalysts faster and better. This is fundamental to the energy usage in Africa and around the world.
And looking at how you've positioned yourself as SandboxAQ, well, you are literally at the intersection of deep tech and industry. Perhaps talk to me about which sectors are best positioned to benefit from innovations right now.
Well, Abby, in addition to the energy sector, let's talk about the biopharma sector. Africa and everywhere in the world, we have challenges in terms of different diseases, cancer, diabetes, heart attacks. Heart attacks, again, number one killer in much of the world, including many of the countries in Africa. What can we do about this? How can we accelerate the discovery of new drugs and deploy these new drugs faster across the continent of Africa and around the world? Well, the traditional way of doing that before AI came takes about 10, 15 years. Clinical trials take a long time, and often we see failure in those trials. What we're doing now with AI for the physical world, this is a new kind of AI, these quantitative models that understand biology, that understand chemistry. We're now able to work on cancer, on brain cancer, on Alzheimer's, on dementia. And we just announced a model that is focused on this, the SAIR, the SAIR model at SandboxAQ, which allows us to focus on areas where we can quickly develop these kinds of health-saving, life-saving treatments and diagnostics. Another area that we can focus on with AI, Abby, is water treatment. In much of the world, we're still looking at challenges in terms of getting clean water. And half the beds, patient beds in hospitals in many countries in the world are filled with patients that unfortunately are succumbing to diseases that are waterborne diseases. Again, AI that's focused on material science, on better desalination, better cleaning of the water. These are areas that we can help the 2 billion people that do not have access yet to clean water. So we need to move not just from AI for the digital world, but now AI for the physical world, working with such, you know, such partners as NVIDIA, as Google, many others as well.
And you raise a very fundamental point there, Jack, that touches on to my next question, and this is the safety of the cybersecurity space. And quantum safe cybersecurity, is this becoming a global priority for you? And perhaps how urgent is this transition for African governments and financial systems?
Great question, Abby. Cybersecurity is fundamental to national infrastructure. It is fundamental to national defense for every country. what we're seeing right now, for example, in the Russia-Ukraine war, it's not just a kinetic war. It's not just the war of drones and missiles, but also a cyber war. Each side is using cyber to try to take down the energy infrastructure, water infrastructure, other infrastructure of the other country. It means that in the continent of Africa, more than 50 countries there, we need to really focus on the cybersecurity. That also involves getting ready for the quantum attack. Quantum computers today, Abby, are not strong enough yet to break the cyber that we use, but that day is coming soon, next number of years. So it is incumbent upon all of us, those in the tech sector, those in government, those in policy, to start moving towards the quantum safe algorithms. Here's the good news, Abby. Those algos now exist. NIST, N-I-S-T, from the U.S. government, working with many of the countries in Africa and around the world, have come up with the antidote, with the solution that protects infrastructure, water infrastructure, hospitals, energy infrastructure, governments, against the upcoming quantum attack. We call it Q-Day. Q-Day is coming, and we have now post-quantum cryptography, PQC, that could defend against that. Active Guard from our company, SandboxAQ, is the software that helps people migrate there. We're seeing banks, we're seeing governments adopt it, and it's very, very exciting to see that. But we have a limited time frame, Abby, to make that transition to the post-quantum, quantum-safe cryptography.